I also would argue with you that you probably feel guilty for getting something without a struggle. Imagine if you just got $1 million because something you did work. You didn't struggle for it. You didn't have to work hard to get $1 million. You just got $1 million. Would you feel guilty? Would you feel ashamed? Would you feel bad? Heaven forbid life could just be easy. But we have so many beliefs that we have to struggle, we have to suffer. So in this video, I'd like to talk about three worldviews that we as men typically hold that hold us back with growing with women, and actually in a lot of places in the world. And the first one I want to cover is something that a teacher of mine told me many years ago, and I just really didn't understand at first, so I kind of want to go into a little bit more detail. But he said, Brian, you got to stop trying to fix yourself. You're not broken. And that's all he said. And for a while I thought about that, and I was like, what are you talking about? You're crazy. I wouldn't be in your class if I wasn't broken. If I had nothing to fix, I wouldn't even show up here. And it took me a little while longer to realize what he really meant by that at a deeper level. I had to contemplate it a little bit. And one day it hit me, I'm not broken. He's absolutely right. You see, the nature of life is growth. The nature of life is expansion. Trees never stop growing, but does a tree think it's broken? No, it doesn't. And that's how all of life really works. Once I realized this, I began to change my worldview about who I was. I wasn't broken. I was a man having a life. And I was growing. That's it. If I don't have money and I want to have money, I'm growing into somebody that has money. If I don't have muscles and I want to grow muscles, I'm not broken. I'm just growing into somebody that wants to have muscles. If I'm overweight and I want to lose weight, I'm not broken. I still have a life. I'm still functioning. I'm still getting along. I'm just losing the weight and becoming a man that's skinnier. Whatever you focus on tends to expand. And so what I was doing was focusing on being broken and living out the game or the fake reality that was broken. But in reality, I still had a perfectly functioning life. It was an idea or a concept in my mind. And when you think about this on a much deeper level, it's really powerful. Think of a burned out, old, abandoned building sitting on the side of the road. Is that building broken? Well, not really. That building could be shelter for a homeless family that needs to get out of the rain one night. And it's to them, is it broken? No, it's perfect because they needed to get out of the rain. It protected them. That building could be the backdrop for a photographer for shooting some amazing photos. That building could be a project for a developer that creates a bunch of new homes for family in that area, or becomes a building that's a community center, or who knows what, a new business for somebody. That building is just in a transformational state. Part of growth. It's one of the laws, seven natural laws, the law of transmutation. If a tree is old and isn't really growing leaves anymore and it's got the big tree stump coming out, is it broken? Or is it artwork? Or could it be firewood to keep somebody warm one night? You see, everything is going through transmutation. Everything is transforming from one thing to another, and at no stage is it broken. It's just growing. Is a sapling broken because it's not a tree yet? Is a baby broken because it's not an adult yet? Was Helen Keller broken because she couldn't see or hear? Well, the question I have is, if she could see and hear, would she have created the amazing works she created, the books she wrote? The fact that she went inside so much because she couldn't see and hear might have a lot to do with why she wrote the books she wrote and the art she created. You could say the same thing about Stephen Hawking. So you're not broken. You're growing. You're having a certain experience of life. And just the fact that you're alive means you're working perfectly. So as you change that view, you're going to start to change the way you see the world. When you go to a workshop, you're not trying to fix yourself anymore. You're growing yourself. And I always see this. When you go to the next workshop or function you go to, look at the two groups in the workshop, because there's always two groups. One group thinks they're broken, and one group doesn't see themselves as broken. They're just growing. The group that sees themselves as broken typically has been going to workshops or learning or training for years. They're constantly upset, and, oh, I got this next pain I have to go through. You see a little bit of victim consciousness on them. The group that's not tends to have lots of breakthroughs. Oh my God, this just happened. This is amazing. I'm growing. Oh my God, this happened. I applied your principles. I went out and made money right away. I applied your principles. I met a girl today. Oh my God, it's amazing. Why? Because they don't spend so much time beating themselves up. And so start to play with this new worldview. You're not broken. You're perfect just the way you are, and you're growing, and that's it. And that leads me to the second thing. The second worldview that typically holds men back from becoming really good with women fast, or any area of their life, money, doesn't really matter, is that it's difficult to change. that it takes a lot of hard work, that I have to struggle, I have to suffer. It doesn't mean anything if I don't suffer first. That I beat myself up inside so that I work harder. That if the more I beat myself up, the harder I work. And that attitude is just plain false. I'd argue that you've been beating yourself up your whole life, so you've told yourself the story that if you beat yourself up, you'll work harder. But in reality, if you just stop beating yourself up, you'll grow much faster. I also would argue with you that you probably feel guilty for getting something without a struggle. Imagine if you just got $1 million because something you did worked and you didn't struggle for it. You didn't have to work hard to get the $1 million. You just got the $1 million. Would you feel guilty? Would you feel ashamed? Would you feel bad? Heaven forbid life could just be easy. But we have so many beliefs that we have to struggle, we have to suffer. We look at our family, maybe our father struggled, our mother struggled, and as part of our bond with them is talking about how we struggle. Maybe we hang out with groups that talk about how hard everything has to be. And in reality, does it have to be hard? If you look out there are people that have an easy life. Life is just easy for them. They don't struggle, they don't toil, they just enjoy. Why can't that be you? What if you just started to change your thoughts in this area and your feelings? I started to play with the idea that life is easy. Life flows naturally. Life happens in an easy, relaxed way. And you start to let go every day a little bit more of that belief that life has to be hard or that I have to be a martyr. You create your reality. So quit creating a reality where life is difficult. Simple as that. And start telling yourself every day life is easy. With each of these, don't expect them to turn around overnight. Maybe they will, maybe they won't. But if every day you keep meditating on the idea that life is easy, and life unfolds naturally and effortlessly, and then life keeps growing. Imagine if you, in 30 days, how much you will look at that differently, 60 days, 90 days, a year, and how much different your life could be. And now with this belief, I had one little caveat. I was afraid to really take on this belief because if life became easy and started to flow naturally and started to open up and I didn't have to fight my way to the top, there was a fear inside of me that life would become boring. And I would be bored all the time. And it took me a little bit to even let go of that one. I had to play with that for a bit. And as I started to look at the happiest people in the world whose lives just unfold, who they do a lot of amazing things, I began to realize none of them look bored. Matter of fact, they looked like they were the happiest, having the most fun. They were the ones winning the marathons and inventing new stuff and starting amazing businesses, traveling the world, taking vacations in Bali and Thailand and skiing the world. And I began to realize I want that life. You see, one of the things I do, and this is another secret, is when I want to develop a new mindset, I look for as many people as I can find living that mindset, and I look at what their life's like. I want to associate, be around, think like those people. And if you start to see it, you'll start to believe it. And then the other thing I do is I start to adopt it first thing in the morning. I always meditate on these ideas first thing in the morning. So that brings me to the third thing. And the third thing is the strongest worldview when it comes to dating. I see this a lot, and all of these point to a positive reality, having a really positive reality from positive psychology. And this third worldview is that women don't like me, period. Or women don't like men, or men have to trick women into bed, or women don't like sex. This is a big one. Women don't want sex as much as I do, and we have to get them to have sex with us. And this is just total bullshit too. In reality, women love sex. They crave sex. Their bodies are sex. They're built for sex on average. I'm not saying there's not asexual women and men out there, but there are. But for the most part, they really want sex. They have a different approach to it and different mindset about it, but they love sex and they really enjoy it. They believe in it. And when they meet a man that never shames them for sex, that believes in sex, that loves sex, they get really excited because so many men today hold shame around sex. And when they meet a man who knows he's attracted to women, they love being attracted to him. It's that simple because they have permission. They have permission to be free with him and open with him. So I want to invite you into this idea that you're male. You're built to be attracted to women. If you're masculine at all, you're built to polarize women, which is nature's natural law of attraction. It's a natural law, the law of polarity that polarizes the feminine towards the masculine. It's the reason we're still alive as a race today, because men and women have been having sex forever, been attracted to each other forever, turned on forever. And so what I want to invite you to do is do what I talked about with the last worldview, which is start to look out in the world at all the women that are drawn to men. Look at the cover, look at the magazine rack at like Cosmo, Cosmopolitan, and all these different magazines, and notice how many articles are about men, drawing them in, how to get them, how to win them over. and how crazy women are about this stuff, about how sex and different types of sex and how to have more sex, and start to really look out in the world at how many women are actually thinking about this all the time. If you go read My Secret Garden, which is a book on women's fantasies, look at the novel like 50 Shades of Grey and look at how many women went nuts over that book. You see, this stuff is deeply rooted inside of them. And men that get this, men that are naturals, don't think they have to trick women into bed. They know women want a hot guy to sleep with, and a hot guy is energetic, not your literal looks. A guy who believes in himself, a guy who likes sex, a guy who likes women and their bodies and likes sex with them. That's the guy they want to open up for. So the more you believe that women are drawn to you, the more you believe that women love sex, the more you're going to meet them. And I wanted to add one more piece to this. I've met a lot of guys that have every reason to be good with women. They have they have tension skills, they're solid, they're grounded, they're masculine, but they still don't have women. Why? For the simple reason that they believe it's hard to get women. Not because they don't have the insane skill set and the ability to get women, but they believe it has to be work, just like the second belief. They believe that they have to do something special. And when they drop that belief, they're often shocked at how many women show up in their life. And I've also run into men that don't have really technically good reasons to be having a lot of women in their life. Maybe they don't fit all the stereotypes, but yet they have more women they know what to do with. More hot women they know what to do with. Why? Because they believe, know, and feel in their bones that women like them. And why can't that be you? So I want to invite you to take all these worldviews every day. I want you to explore people that have these views that are succeeding in the world. I want you to see it in the world, like I talked about. Then I want you to meditate on them a little bit every morning. Just sit down, still your mind, go into a meditation, and then after about 10, 15 minutes of meditation, just focus on these beliefs and just sit and think about and meditate, contemplate. It's really contemplate and feel it in your body. Imagine you could feel it in your heart, your stomach, and all the way down here in your pelvis and your turn on, and drop those beliefs in and just see if you get each part of your body buzzing with the thought of those beliefs. And in 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, you will see huge, huge improvements in these areas if you keep it up consistently. With that said, I really want to hear your comments on this one, especially after you've been doing it for 30 days, 60 days, and 90 days. But even right away, if you got more questions about it, you're curious, you want more videos like this, you know, put it down in the belief section. So just watch. These three worldviews alone can have a radical shift on your life. So I especially want to hear the comments. Comment below. So if you like this video, make sure to hit that like button. And then make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button so it shows up in your story feed. And with that said, remember, only the confident really live. See you in the next video.